do that with your high-end surf reels, guys. G'day guys, today I'm here to talk to you about probably some of Australia's proudest fishing history, a company that prides itself on being Australian owned and built still. And that of course is the Elvy. Now the Elvy is something that I honestly don't believe that any Australian fisherman has never heard of. They're a reel that I believe gets too easily overlooked for a multitude of different reasons and reasons that I'll explain later on. But when it comes to a tough surf reel that is almost unbreakable, you simply can't go past these reels. Let me show you why. Come up here for a minute with me. That's beach sand. Now the beach sand where we are is fine. Very fine, it gets into everything. Go on, oh, that's not enough. Could you do that with your expensive surf reels? But now you're probably looking at it going, well, how are you going to clean that off? Well, let me show you.
Come on.
Oh, look at all that sand going around. We'll go down here. Beautiful. Look at how clean that is. That's right, guys, and this is another model. And that's because Elvy has got so many different models of their side cast reels. Now, why would you choose an Elvy? Well, how I'd respond to that is, why wouldn't you choose an Elvy? See, we're talking a reel here that, as you've just seen, is probably the toughest on the market by a long shot. In fact, I don't believe, put this back in the rod holder, I don't believe you can do what I just did to that yellow Elvy with any spinning reel or overhead reel on the market. In fact, I can guarantee you wouldn't do it. The thing is all that we need to do now with that yellow reel when we get home is give it a quick once over. What's the once over entail? Well, look, how about you quickly join me now and I'll show you exactly what it entails. And this, how you maintain your Elvy once you get home. Yep. That's it, done. And how easy was that to do? Super simple, super basic. Now let's talk about some of the many pros of an Elvy reel. In a time where I see on the internet from a daily basis, everyone going, support Australian, but support our local guys rather than our overseas counterparts or overseas relations, it's the perfect time for you guys to put your money where your mouth is and support an Australian company. I, for one, are super proud to support this company. Second of all, how would you like to outcast your mates? Because with the Elvy, you can do just that. You see, with the Elvy having such a big spool and such large surface area, they outcast the rest by a mile. Now I'm running 20 pound monofilament on this 65 here, and this 20 pound monofilament will outcast or match any of the guys with braid on the beach. One of the other features that I absolutely love, and it's a huge advantage, is your bite detection. Now we're running these on Gary Howard MT8144s. This one's an MT7144. And because you've got the direct bite with your index finger on the line, you feel absolutely everything, even a whiting. And that's whilst using monofilament. Now don't get me wrong, Elvies have their cons, as does everything. And probably the biggest con with an Elvy is the retrieve. Okay, so with an Elvy, it's a 1-to-1 retrieve ratio. One turn is one rotation of the spool. That means that your Elvies are incredibly slow to wind in with. So whilst your mates will burn a 100 meter gutter in, I don't know, Lance Armstrong speed, you're gonna be sitting at the back of the pack with the turtles. But that's okay, because with that one-on-one drive, it means that nothing's going wrong. There's no moving parts, there's nothing going on. It's just as simple as retrieve the thing. I've seen guys winch snapper straight up the cliffs at Steep Point with these without a drama. When you turn the side caster on its side and your loops are coming off, you twist your side caster back for a direct spool or direct drive, that twist stays in your line. So it's important you use super high quality, very small swivels. The smaller the better. And one thing I learned from an LV rep is that match the swivels to your line. So if you're running 20 pound line, there's no reason you can't use a 25 or a 30 pound swivel, which is usually about a size 10 or 12. Now that seems absolutely minuscule, but remember, it's higher than the line's breaking strength. So you're gonna be okay. The smaller the swivel, the quicker it and easier and more fluently it turns and takes that line twist out. By using small swivels, you simply eliminate 90% of the line twist. When I get home, I usually, as a habit now, I'll strip off the first 20 meters of line off my LV into a nice fresh bucket of water or into the bath, and I'll wind it back on through my fingers to straighten out that last bit of line. I usually take 4 or 5 twists out of it. So it's not huge, but it's something, and it's just a habit to get into. Guys, I insist you go over and at least have a look at the LV website. They've got so many different reels now. They've just introduced the Orbit, as well as a bait caster and a high-end slow pitch jigging reel. Have a look, see what they're all about, guys. Share them a bit of love and tell me what you reckon. All right, guys, until the next episode, we'll catch you later.